Hello and welcome everybody to Quality Sewing and Vacuum's virtual How Do I Today. My name is Andrea and I am so excited to share with you this really cool table runner trick. I love it. I use a lot of table runners around my own house and this was just such a fun, different way to make a table runner. Today we are going to talk about the 10 degree ruler, which I have right over here. It's a wedge ruler and it does come with a little instruction booklet, but I want to show you some of the really cool things that we're going to be making. We have a local artist. Her name is Connie Spurlock from So Wonderful Dreams. She made this fun pattern for us to make this kind of wonky table runner that swivels back and forth like this. Isn't that so fun? I love that. And it's all done with the wedges. So you can do it this kind of wonky, curvy way, or you can do it, put that right there, as the straight way, where these ones were made into placemats. So using the same wedges, you can either make this curvy table runner or you can make a long straight table runner, either way, or placemats in this case. So let's kind of dive into it really quickly. I've got this piece of fabric right here. Now it doesn't matter how wide you make your strips, as long as you cut all your strips the same way. This also was made out of the same method, but just little tiny pieces right here. And I love this because this will be really great on like a vanity where you put like your jewelry and everything. Super, super cute. Gail made this one and she did gold thread edging on here. She satin stitched the edges a couple of times to get that nice thick sparkly edge. Super cute. And then you can see here, she also did the same thing. These are the same wedge sizes as this one, but she just did them every other one. So how do you get this curvy, fun, wavy edge? Is you take a certain amount, however many you want to, and make a fan out of them. The more you put in the fan, the curvier it's going to be. This was Ann Almonds from up north in Bellevue. She did 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 wedges in a row, and she just flipped them every other one and sewed them together and did this fun curvy table runner. Now, when you do the binding on your table runner, you want to make sure that you do use bias binding, which means it is cut on the bias, means it's going to be flexible as it goes around these wonky curves. Just wanted to give you that tip. It does look like her fabric was actually printed on the bias. So when she cut it out, it was straight. It was on the bias, you know what I mean? Does that make sense? Like this fabric right here is actually straight, but the print is on the bias. So anyway, let's move on. We've got our piece of fabric right here. Now, in order to do like this combination of fun little colors here, every other one, you can whack and stack, which means you can layer up your fabric, your different fabrics like this, and then use your ruler and cut many layers at the same time. So with what that looks like is I'm going to lay my ruler down here. I'm going to cut off that edge that isn't the right size. And then you're just going to move it from side to side, back and forth like this. And once you cut one edge, you just cut the other and it makes the next edge for each one. Okay, let's look at some ways that you can do this really cool wavy edge. I've got some samples right here. Here is some Halloween ones. I'm going to move that over. We've got a couple of these. Now, these ones have eight little wedges in here. So if I put a wedge of eight here and a wedge of eight here, and a wedge of eight here, you can see how it starts to develop this really wonky, curvy, fun table runner right here. And then you can add another one. Look at how fun that is. I love how Anne made this with these fun, bright Halloween-y colors. It makes it just really, really fun. But what if we switch these up a little bit? Watch what we can do with this. When you use a 10 degree table runner pattern, you can also use these to make a tree skirt. I'm trying to make these colors so they don't matchy match. So you can kind of see everything here. Well, I did my best. Okay, so notice that there's a hole in the middle of here and a hole on the edge. Woohoo! You can, if we had one more, it would make one more of these little sections. It would make a complete circle. But you can make a beautiful tree skirt. When you use the 10-degree ruler, you will always have a little hole in the middle here. Notice it doesn't go all the way to the tip there. You'll always have this little hole. So there's many different ways that you can finish up this hole, but let's say you want to just keep it for a tree skirt for your living room. Let's do a little bit of math. I am not a mathematician like at all, but because I'm actually working with fabric, like hands-on, I can totally do this math. It's really simple. I've written it down for you over here, but just in case you don't remember, you can come back, like and subscribe to this page and put a little like star by it. And you can come back to this, or it's also in the little booklet here where you can learn how to create your very own Christmas tree skirt. I love the variety of things that you can do with this. Okay, we are going to, got my little cheat sheet to make sure I'm doing my math right here. Okay. So let's say you want your tree skirt 30 inches wide. So this is the diameter. If you were to slice your circle in half, that's your diameter. So I want my tree skirt 30 inches wide. So I'm gonna put, I want it 30 from this side to this side, 30 inches. That's my finished diameter, 30 inches. And I want my circle in the middle to be, I want a really big tree. I want my tree to be 14, I want my circle to be 14 inches wide. That is a large tree. Okay, so I want that 14 inches in the very center from here to here. So that's my second number is 14 inches. Okay, so in order to find how wide of a strip you need to start cutting those little wedges, from, you need to take A minus C, B, which equals C right here, divided by 2. So 30 minus 14 equals 16. I guess I'll put 16 right here. So if you were to cut your little wedge like this, divided by 2 equals 8. So your width of your fabric that you need to start cutting your wedges from needs to be 8 inches wide this way. Okay. And I don't know if you can see right there. Now these would make a Barbie Christmas tree, but this is just gets to your idea of how you would start cutting your little wedges out. And you can notice how the wedges aren't exactly the same. It will still come out either way. If you want to make some really wide and some kind of narrow, as long as you cut 36 of them out, you will make a complete circle. How cool is that? Math can be so cool sometimes, especially when you make beautiful things from it, right? Okay, so if you are making a tree skirt, just make sure that you just don't keep one of these wedges out. Just don't sew one of those in there. Right there, so you can get it around your tree. So anyways, okay, so I love using a 10-degree ruler because the math is really easy because I am not a mathematician, like I said. There are 360 degrees in a circle with a 10-degree ruler. That means you need 36 wedges. And like I said, it doesn't matter if you make some wide, some thinner, as long as the strip of fabric is the same from here to here, you're going to get the right, the whole circle out of it. Okay, so how do I know where to cut? Now I know my width of my fabric needs to be 8 inches, but where do I cut on my ruler? How do I know that? So this is super easy too. You can take some notes here. So you take your, the complete diameter, which is 30 inches, and you divide that by 2, which makes 15. So my top mark, I find 15 on my ruler, which is right here. Ta-da! I find that's my first measurement. And then I need to take the measurement of the hole in the middle, which is 14, and I divide that by 2 as well, easy peasy, which is 7. And I mark that on my ruler right here. So now I know how wide my fabric needs to be, and now I have where I need to cut on my ruler for here and here, and I am good to go, and then I am ready to make the most fantabulous tree skirt ever, or table runner, or placemats, or a skirt for a little girl. You can come back over here, and let's look at this again. Or it could be for a big girl too. You can also do that. There's so many more things you can do with this, but this is just a brief introduction of what all you can do with these really cool table runners. So look at this. So if you wanted to make a skirt for our little girl, like a twirly skirt with a twirly dress, you could take a t-shirt, a regular old t-shirt that you get anywhere for just a couple bucks, and you could attach a twirly skirt like this to the bottom of it, and that little girl would be totally thrilled with it. Same idea. Like if you go over to our measurements here, this middle measurement right here would be the waistband. So this is how big the waist you would want to be. Now, let's say her waist is actually 14 inches. You would want to make sure that you add at least like 3 to 4 inches onto that to match the t-shirt. And so she could get it on and off because this fabric isn't stretchy. And then this would be the length of the skirt right here that she would be wearing. So anyways, I hope that you are inspired, that this 10 degree ruler was really exciting for you. Let me know if you have any other questions, because there's just so much you can do with a 10 degree ruler, really fast, really easy. And if I can do the math, you can do the math too. I hope you have a creative day, and we'll see you next Tuesday.